Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm gonna do my March favorites, and I'm also gonna talk about some products that I was disappointed with. If you're new to my channel, my name is Sylvia. I do makeup, fitness, health, and lifestyle videos. So if you are interested in those topics, please consider subscribing. And if you end up liking this video, please give it a thumbs up. That will let me know that you guys like my content and that I can continue to make videos like this for you guys. Let's go ahead and get right into this video. Alright, so first I'm gonna talk about my beauty favorites and then I'm gonna move on to fitness and other products. So if you're not into beauty, you can fast forward and go where I talk about fitness and other products. And as always, I'm gonna link everything down below in the description box. First, I'm gonna talk about the Mikasa E320 brush. So I got it around the beginning of March and I've been using this brush all the time. It's just a tapered brush, so it goes up like that and it's like a little bit fluffy, but then if you turn it around, it's kind of wide as well. So you can basically use it for blending or use it for the crease as well. So I really like this brush, and I think it's like a dupe of the MAC 217 brush, one of my favorite brushes. This one, it's all beat up, as you can tell. They're both tapered. They both have about the same width, except for the Mikasa one is just a tad bit more pointy than the MAC brush. And also the handle of the Mikasa one is longer, which I do like that. And it's a lot less expensive than the MAC 217. So I think that's what I love most about this brush, because it's so much cheaper than the MAC 217. And we all know the MAC brushes are very expensive. So I'm really glad that I found this one. There are other brushes that are really great too. I do recommend that you guys check them out. And I do also have a discount code. If you guys want 25% off, you can get this brush for like, I don't know, like $8, which I think that's a really good deal for these brushes. These are very nice. Their customer service is great. Moving on, I'm gonna talk about this Makeup Forever liquid matte lipstick in the color 109. So Makeup Forever came out with new liquid lipsticks, and I was really interested because I think I heard Jaclyn Hill talk about the new lipsticks and that they have really good formula, and I just loved this one that I got, and I had been wearing it all the time in March. I just really like these type of pink nude colors. It kind of reminds me of Candy K by Kylie Cosmetics, which is one of my other favorite colors in lipsticks. I'm wearing it right now as well. And the formula is really good. It just lasts all day. It doesn't feel uncomfortable. It doesn't dry out my lip. It just feels like a really thin layer on my lips. And it doesn't make my lips look all crusty. And I just really like the formula. These, they don't have a lot of colors out right now. So I think they have like around 6 colors. But I'm pretty sure that they'll come out with more colors. Moving on to another liquid lipstick, the Urban Decay Vice liquid lipsticks. And I had gotten several liquid lipsticks not too long ago from Urban Decay when they came out with their liquid lipsticks. The color that I'm going to talk about is called ZZ, and these are supposed to be waterproof, long-lasting liquid lipsticks. The reason I really like this color in March is because I think it's just a really pretty color for spring. And I wore this color a lot of times. I did wear it in my last makeup tutorial video. So you guys wanna check it out there, you guys can. So I'm gonna go ahead and swatch it for you guys. Like a lilac color for spring. So yeah, these liquid lipsticks are pretty comfortable too, but I am going to talk about a few at the end of this video. All right, so next I'm going to talk about this Maybelline Fit Me powder. It's the matte and poreless in the shade 220 natural beige. It says that it's for normal to oily skin, and I just wanted to find a new setting powder. Normally I use the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish powder, but I just wanted to find one from the drugstore, and I ended up trying this one out, and I've been using it nonstop in March. I kind of haven't really been using the MAC one. I just think it's a really good powder for setting your foundation. It's not super pigmented. It's like a light powder to set your makeup. So I wouldn't recommend it to use it as a foundation. So this is a really, really good powder. All right, so I did end up getting some Kylie highlighters in March, and I'm going to talk about the two favorite colors that I liked. So this is the packaging. They pretty much match the color of the highlighter, and it's pretty simple packaging, which I really like. It's like a glossy finish, and then the letters are matte. And the two colors that I really, really liked were French Vanilla and Cotton Candy Cream. I also ordered Strawberry Shortcake and Salted Caramel. So I'm wearing both right now on my cheeks, and the reason I really like these highlighters is because they kind of look like they make your skin glow and like it looks kind of wet. And that's what I like about a highlighter. I don't like highlighters to be chunky glitter. Those tend to accentuate my texture on my skin, and I feel like these I can bring them all the way down and they just give this really nice glow. They're not like bam, oh my gosh, in your face highlighters. They're just basically just melt into your skin. They're silky formula. If you rub your finger on the highlighter, it's just super silky. It feels kind of wet, but it's not. It's kind of like a cream. So this is the swatch of Cotton Candy Cream. Let me do a swatch of French Vanilla. So this is like a icy gold. So there is a swatch there of French Vanilla. And I think this one is more pigmented than Cotton Candy Cream. But that's it swatched on my hand. Let me swatch Cotton Candy Cream right next to it. So they look pretty similar, except French Vanilla is a little bit more pigmented and Cotton Candy has just a hint of champagne. There you go. So that's Cotton Candy Cream and that's French Vanilla. So if you want one that's more pigmented, I would say go with French Vanilla. If you don't want one that's super pigmented, you just want like a beautiful glow, I would say go with the Cotton Candy Cream. But I really, really like how it looks on the skin. It's just glowy. I love it. So a palette that I'm going to talk about next, it's the Nicole Guerrero Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit. So these are all the colors and they're just really, really beautiful colors. I think for the summer and spring, you can also like use this color right here for your body in the summer, which what I intend to do. I am going to say I did like the Kylie ones more than the Anastasia one, because the Anastasia ones, they're really pigmented as well. So I just swatched this one right now, that's Glow Getter. And as you can see, it's like super pigmented. Let me go ahead and swatch this one. There you go. That one is Forever Lit and it's just extremely pigmented. These don't feel as smooth as a Kylie highlighters, but they are still pretty smooth. But when I put these on my face, they do accentuate my texture more than the Kylie highlighters. But I really do like the Forever Lit color that I had just swatched. Really bright highlighter. And I like using that one in the inner corners of my eyes, which I am using it today. If you are looking for a whoa highlighter, this is a really good palette. Okay, so moving on, I'm going to talk about these new Icon eyelashes in the style Black Dahlia. So you guys probably know I've been on a hunt to find some good lashes that I really love and that I would want to wear all the time, and I think I found my favorite lashes. These are super fluffy, super soft. I'm wearing them right now. I just feel like they really go good with my eye shape. They're really comfortable. They don't feel like heavy on my eyes like other eyelashes, and they're not hard for me to apply. I've been wearing these a lot if you've seen them on my Instagram pictures. I have them on like in almost all the pictures, and I'm really happy because I was able to get a discount code on these eyelashes, which is MUA Sylvia, and you can get 35% off from these lashes. So you end up paying, I think, like $20 for these lashes, which I think it's really good. You can use them from 10 to 20 times. And compared to the Lily lashes, they are a little bit more cheaper than the Lily lashes. And I think that they're still really great quality, like the Lily lashes. So if you want glam eyelashes, I would recommend these Icon eyelashes. All right, so for the last beauty item, I'm gonna talk about this Teddy Organic Rose Water. I've been using this rose water all month and I pretty much ran out. And this is 100% pure organic rose flower water. That's all it has on the ingredients. I really love their rosehip oil, so I ordered the rose water to try it out, and I just really, really love it. I use this after I take a shower. I get out of the shower and then I just spray my face really quickly just to hydrate it, because my skin gets really dry after washing it. I also do that after cleaning my face and taking off all of my makeup. I will spray this on and then I put on my moisturizer. It can cleanse and hydrate the skin as a natural toner and help tighten pores. It is a natural solution for maintaining the skin's pH balance and soothing redness and irritation. I just really like how it makes my skin feel refreshed and instantly hydrated, because I just need that instant hydration right away after I wash my skin, and then I go in and I put my moisturizer. This rose water is not expensive at all either. I got it on Amazon, so I will link it down below as well. One thing I am gonna say is that the spray on this bottle, it could be a little bit harsh. You can transfer the liquid to a different bottle where the spray is a little bit more like a mist. I do that with this one. So that's the only thing about this product that I didn't really like, but it's really great because it's only one ingredient. All right, so moving on to other products I'm gonna talk about is this right here. This is my baby. I take this everywhere with me. I always have a water bottle with me because hydration is super, super, super important. You have to drink water all the time. Our bodies are made mostly of water, so you need a lot of water to have beautiful skin, beautiful hair, and just to flush your liver out from toxins. You need to be drinking water all the time. Oh, so we went to Target and I saw this water bottle there and I was like, oh, that looks nice, let me check it out. And it's a glass water bottle. So that automatically got my attention because glass is way better than plastic and any other material because it has less chemicals that leach onto the water. Even if the container is BPA free, they put other chemicals in there and that can be harmful as well. This is a glass water bottle and I love that they put this cover on it. It's like a rubber cover, so if you do end up dropping the water bottle, this cover basically protects it from breaking, because I have had a glass water bottle before and I dropped it because I'm super clumsy and it broke. But when I went to Target and I saw that it had this sleeve that protects it, I was like, holy cow, like that's perfect. Sleeve is also BPA free. I didn't even know that. I just saw that right now. Another thing that I love about this water bottle, the cap is like my favorite thing about this water bottle. This water bottle has a button here in the front. So you just press that button and the cap opens up. You don't have to twist it off. You don't have to pop it open. You don't have to do any of that. You just press that button and it just opens and you can just drink your water. Like, I freaking love that about this bottle. Another thing about this water bottle, it has a lock feature on it. So this little part right here, so you can lock the top and it will not open. So if you press the button here, I'm pressing it and it will not open. So I can just throw this in my backpack, in my gym bag, and anywhere, and it is not going to open. So, isn't that freaking cool? It comes with this like little handle here, and you can just put your finger on there. So I use this all the time. The other water bottle that I had, it didn't have a handle. It didn't have any type of thing where I can just grab it. So this makes it so much simple when I'm carrying a bunch of stuff with me. I always use the little handle, and I love that it has this. Yeah, this bottle is freaking awesome. It's 20 ounces, so you can put a bunch of water in here. Guys, I got this water bottle for like 10 or 11 bucks. It was on sale at Target, and I think regular price is like $14. I am gonna link it down below. On the website, it's on sale as well. If you want, you can twist off the cap to wash it, and then you just twist it back on. And it's pink, so I love that. They have other colors as well. So moving on to another fitness product, I'm gonna talk about the Organifi Green Juice Superfood Powder. So if you're following me on social media, you guys have seen me drinking this green powder every morning. It's basically just a green powder. It comes with a little scoop, and you put it in your water, your smoothies. You can sprinkle it on salads, whatever you want. I have tried other green powders and they all taste like crap. I have not been able to try a green powder that tastes good. And I just think that a green powder is really important for anybody to take, because, you know, a lot of us are not getting our vegetables in every day that we're supposed to be getting. So we're missing out on a bunch of nutrients and minerals that our body needs, and vitamins. So I always incorporate a green powder in my routine. So I ended up ordering this because it said that it was voted best tasting greens powder. And when I tried this powder, it was so good. I only need to mix it with water. My other powders, I did have to mix it in a smoothie for me not to be able to taste the powder. But with this one, I can just drink it with just water, and it tastes freaking good. So it's organic, it's gluten-free, soy-free, dairy-free, vegan, and it has wheatgrass, it has spirulina, it has chlorella, it has matcha green tea, which you guys have heard me talk about green tea, that it's anti-aging, it helps detox the body, and it has antioxidants. It helps prevent cancer. So matcha green tea is amazing. Also, it has coconut water, it has organic ashwagandha, which is great for managing stress. It has organic turmeric, which I take turmeric almost every day, and the fact that I have it in this powder, I don't have to take it separately because it's already in here. Basically, turmeric is great for anti-inflammation. So if you have inflammation within your body, which most of us do because of the American diet, turmeric powder is great for inflammation. I just really love this green juice powder, and it is totally worth it. And it lasts me a while because it's a big bottle. They don't sweeten this with sugar or anything like that. So it doesn't have any sugar in there. It doesn't have artificial colors, nothing like that. And these other ingredients, wheatgrass, spirulina, chlorella, they're all gonna be able to detox your body. The reason that's important is because we all are exposed to a bunch of toxic chemicals. I mean, all this makeup, the truth is that it has a lot of chemicals on there, but I just love makeup. But it does have a lot of chemicals, and I am putting it all on my skin. We're also exposed to a bunch of chemicals from the water we shower with. It has chlorine. We're also exposed to, you know, from soaps. Basically, a lot of factors where we're exposed to toxic chemicals. So I think it's super important for people to be detoxing their body with food first, whole foods. So vegetables, fruits, beans, grains, nuts, seeds. So whole foods, and also by taking some type of superfoods that help detox the body. So this is made of a bunch of superfoods and it helps detox the body. So I make sure to take this every single day so that my body is constantly detoxing. So I'll probably end up doing a whole video separate about each of the superfoods that is in it and what are the benefits of each superfood. So I am thinking about making a separate video just about this green juice powder because I think it's really, really important to incorporate some type of superfoods in your diet. So I do have a discount code for this green juice powder, so I will link it down below. The next item that I'm gonna talk about, leggings. So I ended up getting these leggings from Target. I just really like the design from them. They're like gray, black, and then they have flowers. And then they have like a mesh here so they keep you cool. So it has a zipper on the side so you can put your keys in there. And then on the inside, it has like an orange, bright orange neon color. And then it has straps, but they're just really, really good. The brand is Champion and I wear a size small. I just really, really like these in March and I was wearing them all the time. All right, so moving on to the products that disappointed me in March. It's just a couple of two products. It's two of the Vice liquid lipsticks, Studded and Trivial. So not all of the Urban Decay liquid lipsticks were good. These two were not my favorite. And I don't really like talking bad about products, but I just feel that, you know, it's good to know. This one is Studded. When I would apply it, it was super patchy. So let me go ahead and swatch it on my hand so you guys can see. And it was sheer as well. So as you can see, it's like pretty sheer. You can still see my skin through. Especially when I would apply it on my lips, it was really patchy. So I didn't like this liquid lipstick at all. The other one that I got is Trivial. It's supposed to be a comfort matte. It just wouldn't really show up on my lips. It looked really like my own lips because this one was pretty sheer as well. So I wasn't really crazy about this color. It wasn't as pigmented as the other colors that I got, like ZZ and Firebird. But that's the other one right here. This is Trivial. It's not extremely pigmented. You can still see like my veins through it. This one wasn't really my favorite either. So, yep, those were the two products that I was disappointed. All right, guys, so those were all the products for March that I really loved and then a couple of products that I was disappointed with. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and make sure you check the description box below for any discount codes or links. If you guys are interested in seeing my other favorites, go to bit.ly/SylviaFitBae shop and you guys can see my other favorite products. Please subscribe to my channel. It doesn't cost you anything. It just supports my channel and shows me that you guys enjoy my content and you guys want to keep seeing my videos. And turn on the bell that is next to the subscribe button so that you are notified every time I upload a new video. So I'll see you guys next time. I appreciate you guys so much and I'll talk to you later. Bye. Makeup Forever came up.